We are live at Sapphire Now 2018 in Orlando. I'm Michael Krigsman. I'm an industry analyst and the host of CXOTalk. And right now, I'm so excited to speak with Patrick Thompson, who is the Chief Information Officer at Albemarle. Hey, Patrick, how are you?
How are you doing, Michael? Good to be here today.
Tell us about Albemarle.
Albemarle, special chemical company, specializing in three markets. One, lithium carbonate. Second, bromine. And then third, our catalyst business. We're number one or number two in each one of those markets. But predominantly, we're on a growth curve with the lithium business.
So you're in a very, very hot spot in the market today.
Yes, we are. A lot of our customers are creating disruptive innovation. So pretty exciting growth opportunities for our customers, which is driving our growth.
Working with such innovative companies, what does that mean for you? What are their expectations for you as a supplier, as a vendor, as a partner?
Not only are we going through a transformation with S4HANA and SAP, but we're also bringing client track and trace capabilities where a client could go into a portal and kind of see where their delivery of their products are. So that's part of our digital transformation strategy, and that's just one solution we're trying to put together for our customers.
So you're helping with supply chain visibility.
Exactly. The customers today, it's a highly competitive market, so if you can give them better information to plan out their business planning projections and meet their manufacturing delivery times, you're going to, one, retain customers, but two, you're probably going to attract some customers that are interested in that kind of visibility.
What's the role of IT in this?
IT is becoming an enabler, not only to deliver information to our clients, but also to run our plants at maximum capacity by tying operational technology in with IT to bring visibility to where the plant needs to be maintained or maintenance needs to be applied before the plant shuts down to keep the plant running, you know, as close to 100% as possible.
Now, you drew the distinction between a business-led project and an IT-led project, and would you elaborate on that distinction?
By putting them in the lead role, they are leading. It's their success, it's their failure, and it's no longer IT being a scapegoat to a large ERP project.
So you clearly define these projects as business projects, and the ultimate responsibility for achieving the business goals therefore lies with the business.
These projects, you know, tend to be very expensive, so we wanted to see what kind of return we would get on that capital investment. And the only way to do that is to get the business involved in signing up for actually making that reality at the end of the project.
We hear the phrase, data is the new oil. How does that figure into this transformation that you've been describing?
Some of the new technologies like S4HANA now allow you to go against the source of the transactions without building a middle layer, which has been very costly, very expensive, and not always reliable from an integrity perspective.
So how important is this real-time visibility to you?
Speed is usually the weapon against competition. If you have better information faster, you're more competitive.
Given who you're selling to and the speed at which those companies are operating, and you're supplying a critical component to their product, that places even a greater burden upon you to provide that level of speed, the transparency and the responsiveness back to them.
Our customers are very dependent on us. We are actually expanding our facilities. We're spending over $1 billion in expanding our facilities to keep up with the market demands.
What are the opportunities it creates for you to play a leadership role inside your organization?
Getting the right infrastructure and collaboration network in place to run our business transformation system, which is our S4HANA implementation. It's not really an IT play. It's really digital business transformation in this whole digital world that we live in.
When you say digital experience, what does that mean?
client track and trace, just a portal that customers could go in and look at the products we're shipping to them at different stages in the life cycle of delivery. That's a digital experience. You know, they can get that on their phone, they can get that at their desk, they can get that while they're mobile. That's one digital experience. The other one is doing business process automation. We have a purchase agent enter a purchase order. We have someone in the field receiving that. That's an electronic process. But then if we can match it up when the invoice comes in and let the digital world sync those things up, you don't really need to touch that invoice. It just, you can automate that script and let that flow. So that takes out a lot of back office inefficiencies as well.
What are the kind of challenges that a CIO can anticipate if they're going to go through this kind of rapid change that you've been describing? And at the same time, what advice do you have for other CIOs who may be embarking on this kind of project?
If you're embarking upon a big ERP project and you're a CIO, at least have it be co-led, if not led, by the business. Now that's hard for a CIO. Many CIOs have egos, but you got to let that ego and check it at the door and let the business drive the transformation.
I love it. Business-led transformation and business-led IT. Yep. Patrick Thompson, CIO of Albemarle. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Michael.